Welcome to St. Elizabeth of Hungary Parish. On behalf of our congregation, I'd like to thank you for joining us for our Sunday Twilight Music Vespers. You can feel at home even during this quarantine. Aside from silence, that which truly comes closest to expressing the inexpressible is music. St. Elizabeth's offers a quiet, contemplative place to truly take in great classical music. Really, the best way to hear and to enjoy superb classical music performed by world-renowned virtuosos is in the context of a short liturgy, which we will provide for you here. Thank you. Please enjoy.
Thank you.
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may also be. And you will know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him." Philip said to him, "Lord, show us the Father and we will be satisfied." Jesus said to him, "Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and still you do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, 'Show us the Father'? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not speak on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do. In fact, will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father." The Gospel of the Lord.
Today the Gospel is about the way where to not go. And if you look just to the daily experience, I suppose you know this experience, how painful it is when you don't know the way. That is the experience of Thomas. "Lord, we don't know where you are going. How can we know the way?" This is the experience during this closeness in this virus. We don't know the way. We don't know the date when we could go out. We don't know what will happen after the virus. There are just too many questions what we could not answer. And we know how painful is it, how much demotivating us, taking our energy. That's the reality. The question is what we can do with this reality. I think what we can do to build up trust in Jesus. And it's not naivety, it's surely not passivity. No, you have to pray, you have to ask for the Spirit of God, which can help you to discern what is your way. You need to pray for the Spirit of creativity, to know how to make your steps in this very changing time. And you have to ask for the Spirit of courage, that you could really make your steps when you know the way. Use this evening to reflect upon them. Use this evening to pray that you can leave beside all the fears and get the trust and the hope. We need it so much today.